The summer's hottest travel destination may be a strip of roughly 70 miles wide of land and 2,800 miles long. That's where people will experience total darkness during the next Monday's solar eclipse.
And that's turned cities and towns along the path into prime vacation spots. Here to talk about the eclipse expeditions many are taking, Brian Kelly, travel expert and the Points Guy founder. Brian, good morning.
Thanks for having me.
There are people that have planned vacations, some haven't. So what are some last minute tips for people?
Yeah, there are a lot of parties going on. It's going to be a really fun event, you know, almost total darkness for 2 minutes. So you know, the swath of the country, it starts in Portland, Oregon, all the way down. And, you know, you can still book flights. Even though a lot of hotels are sold out in cities like Nashville, I actually called yesterday. If you've got hotel elite status, you can actually get rooms at sold out hotels.
Bump somebody else.
Seriously. Sorry.
So if we're, it starts on the West Coast, what's a good place to go on the West Coast?
Yeah, so the party starts. I mean, Portland, Oregon's a great place. If you've never been, a really good craft beer culture. They have music festivals, so it just starts just after 10 a.m. And they also have really good public transportation. So a lot of car rental companies are sold out, but Portland, it's easy to get around.
If you're down south and maybe are looking for the best spot, where might that be?
So the Carolinas are going to get a really good view of the eclipse. So I recommend going to national parks. Get outside, you know, to see the eclipse.
Yeah.
And so Congaree National Park actually has a Science and Shadows program. Or take your kids to the zoo. So the Greenville Zoo in South Carolina is actually doing a viewing party for the first 1,000 people. So that could be really fun. See how the animals react.
Yeah.
You mentioned calling up Nashville. How about Nashville?
So Nashville, Nash Vegas, that's the party spot, right? There's tons of parties going on. But they, you know, there's also the Great Smoky Mountains, too, if you don't want to party at, you know, a live music place in Nashville. But there's a ton going on. But Nashville, I would say, is probably the hot spot for the eclipse.
Nebraska may not be the vacation destination everybody thinks of in summer, but it's,
but it's the hot spot
now
for the eclipse. Yeah, so the Nebraska is actually going to be the full totality. So for a full minute and 51 seconds right outside of Lincoln. So there's the Spring Creek Prairie, a park, which I think will be the ultimate place to see the eclipse. So, yeah, if Nebraska is not on your list, you should add
it. Sounds
fantastic. And so you think it's not too late to book flights, and you got to be tricky with hotels, though, at some of these.
It's not. Well, guess what? So some airlines are even doing eclipse flights. So Southwest has 5 flights that they're going to be giving out free sunglasses and cosmic cocktails. And Alaska Airlines even has a flight that I think leaves Portland, and it just goes for full eclipse watching. So you gotta, I think it's sold out.
But be on the flight while,
while
that's
right?
going on. What a great
idea.
Wow.
To watch it.
Yeah.
I really like that. That's an interesting idea. Brian Kelly, thank you so much for being with us this morning. We'll have live coverage of the eclipse next Monday, August 21st, right here on CBS.